So you have spent ages crafting your new character, and it looks great in the viewport. General movement around the model, along with individual objects, and even direct editing, all work smoothly with no issues. However, depending on your system, once you try to interact with the rigged armature in pose mode, then moving the controls around can start to feel way less smooth. While any attempt to play back some animation in order to see how it looks and judge if the timing is right, just isn't doable. Even changing the viewport mode from material preview to solid only gains around 3 FPS, still less than half a minimum target rate of 24 frames per second. So, what can we do to make it faster? Let's find out. One of the first things to consider is which version of Blender you are using. Looking at animation playback of 3.4.1 versus 3.5, and it's clear that the developers have boosted performance by a significant amount. Version 3.5 hits almost 9 FPS, while 3.4.1 can only just manage 1 FPS. So if you can, ideally the first thing to do is update to the latest version of Blender. Taking a quick look at the hardware, and we can see that having large multi-core CPUs doesn't help for the most part. The main work is all being done on just one or two cores, with a single core basically maxed out, while the 3D usage of the GPU is just half ticking over. So should you decide on an upgrade, don't discount the single core performance of any new CPU. Chances are many of the mesh objects will have a subdivision surface modifier applied at different levels for viewport and render. Now you could select each object and turn the viewport levels to zero, however there is a faster option. Under the render properties, turn on simplify and set the viewport max subdivisions to zero. All of a sudden the CPU has much less data to process and the playback speed doubles to 20 FPS. Yes, the mesh no longer looks as smooth, but for judging and adjusting animation timing, it still looks fine. We are almost there, but still short of our minimum real-time playback. Our next option is to start hiding objects in the viewport, which make little or no difference for animation. In the case of this character, that means the various buttons and front pocket on the overalls, along with the hair curve based eyebrows and the detailed hair as well, and even the rig. While it removes a lot of geometry detail, especially hiding the hair, playback speed only increases by around 1 FPS. Something else must be holding it back. On closer inspection of the remaining visible objects, we find the cores. Depending on how they are set up, modifiers can add a significant amount of extra processing. In our case, it is the geometry nodes set up on the boots that is slowing things down. With those disabled in viewport, we now hit the required 24 FPS, and by increasing the playback speed, it even tops out at around 28 FPS. The problem is that the visual look isn't the greatest. I mean, you can't easily tell where the character is even looking. One could switch to texture preview, which, while now looking way better, drops playback speed down to around 20 FPS again. A more balanced solution is needed. First thing we can do is create and swap in proxy objects. These are just a more simplified version of the objects we have, with less polygons and detail. The general shape is still all there, but little else. The modifier stack is also reduced, leaving only those required for previewing the animation. While each object is disabled for rendering, since these are only used for viewport playback. For the face, we do much the same thing. In the case of the eyelashes, we just turn off the main render objects and label the more simple control objects we already have for animation rigging. Then it's just a matter of adding new proxy objects for the hair, eyebrows, and pupils. The pupils are just filled in circles that are placed a little above the main eye and then attach to the rig just like the eyes are. So when we move the eyes around, it is much easier to see the direction they are looking in. The final thing to do is make the colours of all the objects look more like they do in a render, without the extra processing of using the real materials. To do this, select the Object Properties panel, and under Viewport Display, change the colour to match the overall diffuse colour of its material shader. Once that is done for all the objects, the last trick is to adjust the solid viewport shading options to use Object as its colour setting, leaving us with a fairly lightweight model that is fully rigged while providing a clear visual presentation. If we play back the animation, it now hits a near solid 30fps the whole time. If you like this technical overview and want to see more, or have specific questions or requests, then please click the like and subscribe, or leave a comment below. If not, that's perfectly fine, and I hope to see you for the next one. Cheers.